There's needles lying around in the streets. Everywhere. Sad to see. It's literally open air drug market right there.
You actually want to see the effect of what's happening at the southern border with the fentanyl crisis, and it's right here at home. To get to the edge of a country, you got to just look at its center, is what I say. So,
well,
here we are.
What's interesting about looking around here is
you've been walking around? We've been walking around
a little bit. I've been to Haiti. It kind of looks like this.
Totally. So
we're sitting here thinking, like, oh, man, you know, thank God we live in the first world. This ain't the first world.
Oh, this is not the first world. Are you kidding me? And the difference is, I mean, I've been to third world parts of India, and actually just back in the 90s, less so even now. Look at what you're seeing, needles lying on the street left and right, just have two rats running by.
Well, a little bit worried.
But it's not just driven by poverty. It's just poverty. And here it's actually inflicted by drug usage, literally crossing our own southern border, taking a town where, like, how does this space actually exist? How does that space actually exist? These are factories. A lot of these buildings used to be old factories that have been hollowed out that are now literally the places where people are using to engage in. It's like an open air drug market is what it becomes. So I don't know how much you've been walking around. We've been walking around some. But it's like an open air drug market in certain places. There was a cop up there, literally just standing beside people exchanging drugs on the street. Some guy's doing crack, but what's a cop gonna do about it? Nothing.